Let me tell you, we would fly out on a press charter. A lot of people didn't sit down. Flight attendants would even sometimes, they didn't sit on my lap, but sometimes they would sit on someone's lap during takeoff. I was on one of the last flights, or within the last few months of when Air Force One actually handed out cigarettes.
I'll never forget being on the Great Wall. And I'm just alone in my thoughts, and I'm thinking, just a kid from Birmingham. It just filled my heart.
You felt like a rock star. When you rode on the back of that station wagon in his motorcade and you're going through town, I just kind of thought, this is kind of like Ben-Hur on a chariot riding through town.
I met my wife while covering President Reagan, so you could say Reagan was my favorite president.
I was 24 years old and I'm traveling with the king. It's like, whoa, this is something else, man. We had it going on.
707 with Ronald Reagan. When you fly with the president, eventually the pilot gives you a certificate.
And I carried this Olympus Pen E camera with me in my pocket everywhere I went.
I read the boys on the bus and he described the camera technicians on the press plane.
Not a normal airplane by any stretch of the imagination.
I was like, this is it, it's real.
If someone during takeoff would roll an orange up the aisle of the aircraft.
We would stand on the food trays and up near the cockpit, and then you would try to surf down the aisle during takeoff, which was also sometimes challenging because you had guys rolling oranges up at you.
As the Russians themselves say, doveriai no provriai, trust but verify.
My first overseas trip with Reagan was to Moscow. You know, here we were in the big bad Soviet Union. It was a very, very interesting and different place than America. You had maids, you know, go through your room and, you know, rifle through your stuff. This was the closest I ever got to Gorbachev.
Hope you'll forgive me for saying that it's good to be back in California.
President Reagan loved California.
That's the address of the White House.
I think he felt energized. He was former governor of California. He would go to his ranch.
Access was very controlled.
CNN and all the other networks would take their all-wheel drive vehicles up the mountain roads so they could get a shot from across the mountain of the president riding horses. And everyone had long telephoto lenses. We had a baseball lens.
He was pretty well insulated from the press.
It was the media was a lot different back then, and I've seen the change, and I'm not sure if it's good or bad, but there were indelible images of President Reagan that we took that are still standing today.
He could communicate, and he was the great communicator. I mean, his speeches were very inspiring. They lifted you up.
He's tall, good-looking, and with his acting ability, he could give a great speech, and it just seemed like he was talking right to you. President Reagan had this phrase that he would say, showing his outside of the beltway persona.
I've always felt the nine most terrifying words in the English language are, I'm from the government and I'm here to help.
He loved saying that. He would always get a big laugh. He cemented his persona as a Washington outsider. It's not a politician. I think Donald Trump is trying to capture some of that Reagan magic. As with the first debate, now the second debate in the Reagan Library, Ronald Reagan will be the 18th candidate on that stage, because I'm sure everybody is going to quote him. I think it'll be pretty inspirational having Reagan's aura around him.
You know you've been in the business for a long time when an airplane or something you flew on or worked on is hanging in essence a museum.